Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and I hope you're enjoying the Christmas time, the vacation time and you're having lots of fun. Today's video is all about lip balms and I really wanted to share this piece of information with you. So let's get started. As I've said, is all about lip balm. Lip balm is really the best, the first essential thing which you want during this winter time, and it becomes really very important to have a good lip balm with you, because whatever I think that whatever makeup you apply, it's just onto your skin, though it gets penetrated, but still it's onto your skin. But lip balm is something you apply onto your lips, and whenever you eat something, that lip balms gets into your body, okay, indirectly. Even your lipsticks, the same goes with lipsticks. Still I will not wear it every time, like 24 hours time, but lip balm is something which I use or we use every time, like we wear it for pretty long time every time we apply lip balm. So it's very very essential to know about your lip balms, okay. So today's video is all about your lip balm. I hope you like this video and please share, please help us to make this community bigger each day, and also click that ting tong button to get all the notification as soon as I upload a new video. You can also follow me on other social medias like Twitter, Facebook, even on Instagram. I'm always available, and whatever you feel like sharing, you can also write an email to me. I would love to read your emails. And those who are in touch with me, they know that how quick I respond or how quickly I respond to any of the questions asked. So now I will not waste much of time and I'll get back to this video. So there are some things you should remember, some chemicals you should know which should be there or should not be there whenever you buy a lip balm. Even I will touch the main, like one of the question is that should your lip balms have petroleum jelly? Is it good for your body? Is it nice? Is it safe? Is it harmless? So I am going to talk about that too. So the first thing, like whenever you buy a good or a lip balm, see to it that you please read the ingredients. That becomes really very very essential before you buy, because you should know what ingredients are there. There are some ingredients which are carcinogenic. You know, parabens is one of the ingredients which is carcinogenic, and usually we avoid it in many of our beauty products, but sometimes indirectly it gets into our beauty products. But mainly if you read the if you read the label, you can have an option to buy or not to buy, okay. So the first thing is parabens. They really are carcinogenic, they are not good for your body. So you should go for any of the lip balm which is free from parabens, okay. So the second thing which you should avoid, or the second chemical which you should look for, is salicylic acid. This is very good, I know, for your skin, like for oily skin or acne prone skin. Even doctors recommend it, like Aditya was recommended by a dermatologist to use a face wash which has salicylic acid. It's good, but in your lip balm it should not be there, just because it will make your lips much dry and it's not a good product or a good chemical in your lip balms. So you should avoid by reading the label again. And the third thing which you should check for is camphor, methanol or phenols in your lip balms. They give that cooling sensation to your lips when you apply, but they are not good for a longer period of time. They make your skin of your lips little dry, and it's not good for your skin. So even you should look for this, like the camphor, then comes methanol and even phenol. Okay, then comes, even while picking up tints or you know fragrance, you should look for, because they are also not good for your lips. Even you should look for like the colors or the fragrance, because some of these have phthalates and they are hormone disturbers, or they disturb your hormones. But I would call it secondary, just because you apply lipstick also and they have synthetic colors and even fragrance in them. So the three things which you should keep it in mind is, one is salicylic acid, the other one is camphor, methanol or phenols, and the third one is parabens. These should not be there. Even I would recommend you to go for a lip balm which is transparent, not for which is not having any color. But also you should look for SPF. It should have SPF, but SPF also, in them they have 3 or 4 chemicals which is not good for your skin or for your lips, like chemical based sunscreen such as oxybenzone, then you have homosalates, and even you have octinoxate. These three is not good for your skin or for your lips. I know it becomes little tedious to look or to hunt for the ingredients, but little much like a very little efforts will really be very safe for you, or in long term will help you out your health, though you're so cautious about your health. So even you should look for these small things also. And the second question comes at, what should be there then, if in case if you're avoiding these chemicals, what should you look for in a lip balm? So a lip balm which has lanolin, bee wax, shea butter, cocoa butter is really very good. They work same, like they have those hydrating properties or to moisturize your lip, those properties, and they are really very good for your lips. So you should look for something which is natural or organic based, naturally made, and rather than going for some chemical products. Like I have seen the Lakme one, I know it was good, I was also applying it, but soon when I came to know about these things, or when I started reading about these things, I have noticed that they don't have their ingredients written. They might be not having, I don't know, but still I would not go for, you know, such kind of lip balms which don't have their ingredients written on it. Even Nivea 1 or 2, like they have 3 to 4 varieties. In one variety it was not written, so I did not pick it up. The one which have written about their ingredients, or one which mentioned their ingredients, are little much safer to opt for. Okay, and now comes the last question, is whether you can use petroleum jelly. Just because even people say, or even researchers have shown, that even petroleum jelly is harmful to your skin. It has those carcinogenic properties. The one which is safe and best is this Vaseline one. The Vaseline one is the safest, just because it has undergone triple purification, or it has been refined 3 times, and this has helped to remove all those byproducts or those harmful chemicals, in layman language, from the product. That it makes it safer to apply, and it's really very good. Vaseline is just the brand name, and it has petroleum jelly. Look for anything like transparent or white one, because you will come to know that it is much more refined. Okay, the refined good quality is the white one. And that's it. I have some of the like products which I have hunted for you, and I will just show you that whether you should pick it or not. The first one is this from Lotus Herbal, and they have all their ingredients written. They have honey, they have raspberry extract. Sorry, I have a bit of cold. Then they have jojoba oil, almond oil, wheat germ oil. So this is very good. because it doesn't have any chemicals. It has all the natural products, and all of these, like the lip balm, approximately they come in the range of 200, like not more than 200, any of the lip balms. So that's it. I didn't want to mention any rate because they're all under 200. Okay, the second one is from this brand Nivea. This has many, like, what do you say, they have chemicals as well as some, they have more of chemicals in them, but they have BHT, they have ingredients written which is very good. These have BHT, which is not good for your lips, and they are carcinogenic. So again, there is an option whether you want to or you don't want to. So BHT is also added in some of our food products. Though, since I am from nutrition field, so I can tell you some of our food products also have. So it is controversial whether you want to use it or not. I'm just letting you know. Then comes the Biotique one, which also says all its ingredients, and they are all like organic or natural, which is a good option to use. And it's also under 150 rupees. Then comes the Himalaya one. The Himalaya one, they haven't mentioned their ingredients, but they have written that it is 100% natural colors, vitamin E and antioxidants. So again, you have to check whether you want to or you don't want to. Then the last one is from Palmer's Cocoa Butter. It has SPF 15. Which is very good. It protects your skin from sun, like it has those sunscreen in it, and it says that it is long lasting and all. But then comes to the chemicals. The chemicals which I have listed is not there in this, so it, you can use it. Then I have one that is Burt's Bee. This is really very nice. You have one, but it's little expensive. You also have Carmex. I don't remember whether that label is not there with me, but it's still very good. Then and it is medicated, so it's really nice. Then comes the third one, the Body Shop one. You can also opt for that in case if you want to go something which is high-end brand. A Body Shop, I haven't used it, but I have read about it like more. That's it. This was all about lip balm. I hope you enjoyed this video too, and do subscribe to our channel, hit the button like, and stay tuned for more and more videos. Thank you so much for all your love, care, support, everything. We have really crossed this milestone just because of you all, and I don't know how to thank you all. And do share to make this family bigger and bigger each day. We are coming with lots more interesting like videos and with interesting concepts. So keep on watching, stay connected with us. Bye.